Similarly, we can repeat this for x cubed plus 1. We have a factor x plus 1 here. And therefore, we need a term x squared such that x times x squared giving x cubed, and plus 1 times x squared give us plus x squared. But however, we have to remove again this plus x squared term, therefore we need to subtract this with x squared. Therefore, we need a minus x squared. And therefore, x times minus x. We get minus here because we need a minus x squared term. Therefore, x times minus x give minus x squared. And then plus 1 times minus x give minus x. And again, we have another outstanding term of minus x. And therefore, we need to add 1x. How can we get plus x? Since we have a x term here, therefore, we need another plus 1 in the second factor. Therefore, x times plus 1 give us plus x, and plus 1 times plus 1 give plus 1. And therefore, these middle terms cancel out with each other, giving us x cubed plus 1. And now we have x squared plus 1 equals to x plus 1 times x squared minus x plus 1.